Phil's first guest is ordinary boy and professional celebrity. It's Preston. I love you, you know that, don't you? Preston appeared on Celebrity Big Brother and then married the winner, Chantel. Preston was worried it would alienate hardcore ordinary boys fans, but luckily, neither of them were in the country. Or existed. Preston is angry now, I can't continue.
I'm fine.
Okay. Phil, Preston, any ideas?
Not really, I'm just still a bit upset about what you said at me at the beginning, so I'm not talking to you.
Well, you know, you can't go on Big Brother and get away with it.
Well, I suppose. That's true.
There's an offended before. I've been listening to your album. It's very impressive.
Good, thank you.
Old tracks written by Preston? Except 2, 3, 4, 6, 7.
I still wrote with them. I was writing with my guitarist. And
sure you did. 9, 10, 11, 13, and 15. Sorry, and I like it though.
Good.
We're going to have fun tonight, Preston.
Oh, we're good. So let me know when it starts.
Let's move on now. The Paris Hilton work was a low point for me. It wasn't what I wanted to be doing. And on top of that, it caused me some real problems with my hair. What? It's a good... Haven't you read it? I don't want to spoil the ending for you. The photo shoot was for the Daily Mail, which made me feel really posh and upmarket.
Oh, you better see, like, I can't believe this. Sorry.
Oh, no, Preston,
no,
come
no,
on.
No, seriously, guy, no.
Preston, we're having fun. Come on, Preston. Oh, no, we can't lose Preston.
I guess he thought he's been voted out.
No. I mean, I only read his girlfriend's book.
That's his wife.
I only read his wife's book.
What's wrong with that?
I can't believe that upset him. I mean, I don't know if he's read it. I read the whole thing and it upset me.
Anyone look a bit like Preston in the audience?
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, you'll be fine. You've just got to sort of look a bit surly. Like that. That's it, perfect. Look a bit surly, and every time he goes there, it's out of order. So,
you chose a really pretty one. He looks great.
Welcome to show business. Hello and welcome to budget late night indie show, Never Mind the Buzzcocks. I'm bitter, snotty-faced little public schoolboy Simon Amstell. And I'd like to begin with an apology. On last week's show, I upset Preston from Preston and Chantel. I realise now that they are better than me. Preston is a wonderful singer, and Chantel invented the popular saying, "Oh my God." I was unfair in my representation of Chantel's book. It's not bad, there are some really interesting bits. Suddenly, okay. I hope we can all move on now. Okay, I mean, I don't want to go on about it tonight. But if people start turning their backs on comedy and walking off panel shows, then the terrorists have won. Anyhow. I'm not going to go on about it. Because, you know, he didn't milk it. He didn't. He just went on Radio 1 to have his say, then cleared the matter up in the NME before breaking his silence on GMTV. So, I don't want to make a big thing about it. So that was what it felt like.
You wrote an episode, didn't you? Or co-wrote?
I did, but...
Here we go.
I'm waiting for the reviews to come in before I start talking about it too much. I like everything.
Yeah.
You know everything.
Yeah.
I like it. You know all books.
Yes.
I like them all. In 1985, Sade performed at Live Aid, but said that afterwards she didn't really get to meet any of the other stars. She just sat in the green room with Midge. You stay where you are, Midge.
Wanker.
Yeah. Good point. I don't want you to worry about this, Nicholas Holt. It does not affect anything in your life. We were just having fun.
I just want to go home.
You move. Okay.
So, see, this is the seat that Preston left. This is the seat that Lemmy left the show on, admittedly, during the retakes. We're just going to have to call this one the ejector seat.
You should maybe get some sort of seatbelt. Thank you all for staying till the end. As a reward, everyone gets a lolly.